The animal kingdom is a fascinating world of weird and wonderful creations, filled to the brim with some of the most incredible and unique creatures that we could ever imagine. While all animals are the result of hundreds of thousands of years of painstaking evolution, in most cases, standing out from the herd often leads to a pretty short shelf life out on the savannah. However, when it comes to these impossibly unique animals, being separated from the crowd is a lifestyle that can only be embraced. Here's 15 unique animals with unbelievable fur markings. Rottweiler with vitiligo. Okay, dog lovers, this one's for you. While Rottweilers may often come with a reputation for being ill-tempered, the truth is that they're really just bundles of love and joy. In fact, in a recent study carried out by Dognition, it was found that Chihuahuas are considered to be far more aggressive than either Rottweilers or Pit Bulls. As with any breed of dog, if a Rottweiler is abused, neglected, or mistreated in some way, it may indeed become dangerous and aggressive. But remember, guys, there are no bad dogs, just bad owners. Well, this little bundle of Rottweiler joy is certainly a well-loved addition to the canine family, and she stands out for having a rare genetic condition not often found in the wonderful world of doggos. Meet Sky from Texas, the 11-year-old Rottweiler who has vitiligo, a skin condition most commonly found in humans, which results in different shades of coloring due to a lack of pigment in the skin. In Sky's case, it is meant that his regular dark shade of fur is now almost entirely white, resulting in a grayish appearance in the areas where the two tones meet. It's thought that fewer than 1 in 100 dogs are affected by vitiligo, but German Shepherds, Old English Sheepdogs, Dachshunds, and Rottweilers are most likely to have it. There are loads of theories about what causes it, but scientists think it's mainly down to problems with the immune system and genetics. Whatever the case, these incredible animals certainly stand out from the crowd. Venus the cat. Alright, it's no secret that there are many famous felines across the internet, whether it's Neon Cat, Grumpy Cat, or whichever piano-playing kitty is the hottest act on Caturday, it's safe to say we're pretty obsessed by cats on the internet. Well, move over, because the most famous feline on the internet was already crowned, way back when in 2012. Meet Venus, the two-faced cat who has taken the world of weird and wonderful felines by storm, with a one-in-a-billion characteristic. Take one look at this curious cat and you can understand exactly why one half of her face is solid black with a green eye and the other half is a set of typical orange tabby cat stripes with a blue eye. You may be thinking, how does a cat end up looking like that? Well, the truth is, it's a complete and utter mystery, and Venus the cat is so rare that scientists believe that there has never been another creature like her. Essentially, the DNA in the two halves of her body appear to come from two completely separate cats. While scientists can fully explain why she has grown black fur on one side and orange tabby fur on the other, what they can't explain is why Venus has a single blue eye. You see, cats' eyes are typically green or yellow, and blue-eyed felines are only ever found in Siamese cats or cats with fully white fur. Considering the fact that Venus is none of those things, it has ultimately resulted in one huge glaring question mark in the world of animal genetics. Incredible. The okapi. Is it a zebra? Maybe it's a horse. Nope, it's none of those. In fact, it's a giraffe. Well, actually, not quite. But they did share a common ancestor over 11 million years ago. What the heck are we talking about? Well, the okapi, of course, one of the most elusive yet incredibly distinctive animals to have ever roamed this good planet called Earth. Although they are now only found in one specific area of Africa, they were believed to have once been abundant to the entire landscape of Central Africa, particularly in the dense rainforest that once populated the continent. And evidence of the okapi was only discovered last century. Incredibly, these animals had been completely unknown to modern naturalists and scientists for thousands of years. Known commonly as the forest giraffe, the okapi looks like a cross between a deer and a zebra, and amazingly, they're considered to be be the giraffe's only living relative. The okapi is native to the Ituri rainforest in the Democratic Republic of Congo, which is now the only place where it can be found in the wild, and their unique characteristics continue to amaze researchers. Believe it or not, but the okapi is considered to be one of the most camouflaged hoofed animals in the wild, as it can perfectly blend into its surroundings thanks to the brown and white stripes on its rump, which mimic the appearance of streaks of sunlight coming through the trees. Strawberry leopard. Forget about the pink panther, because this next puce-colored predator is the real deal. Leopards are incredible creatures, and many of them, such as the snow leopard, are ranked amongst the rarest and most elusive animals on the planet. However, the rarest of them all is a little-known variety known as the strawberry leopard. While African leopards are normally colored with tawny coats and black spots, one male leopard in South Africa's Madukwe Game Reserve has astonished conservationists and researchers alike with its rare genetic condition. The legendary theory on South Africa's strawberry leopard is that he has erythrism, a little understood and rarely researched genetic condition that is thought to cause either an overproduction of red pigment or an underproduction of dark pigment in the skin. The result, in this case, is the leopard's distinctive pink-hued appearance. Astonishingly, this condition is so rare that the strawberry leopard of South Africa is considered to be the only incredible case to have ever been documented in a leopard. Believe it or not, but the unusual condition is thought to most often appear in raccoons, Eurasian badgers, and coyotes. And now, one single leopard. The condition doesn't appear to have liberated the strawberry leopard in any way, and he's considered to be one of the most successful animals in the reserve. Dog with eyebrows. Alright, while this next one is sure to turn a few heads, it's also an astonishing example of how even the most unique animals can still be loved for who they are. Meet Betty, a 5-month-old puppy found on the outskirts of Bratsk in Russia, and who was taken into the care of a local animal shelter. Initially, when the caretakers at the shelter took Betty in, they were convinced that someone had played a cruel joke on the poor animal and had painted human-like eyebrows on her head as some kind of act of horrible vandalism. Well, after they had given her a good wash, it turned out that those eyebrows weren't going anywhere. Believe it or not, but this amazing pooch had been born with them, and it was a case of natural pigmentation occurring on her all-white fur. While it may have taken quite some time for Betty to be housed in a loving home, she did eventually find owners who loved her for who she was, eyebrows and all. As it turned out, the previous owners of this pupper had actually named her Frida, after the legendary Mexican painter Frida Kahlo, who was famously distinguished by her iconic thick eyebrows. Purple polar bear. Alright, while many of the entries on this list are heartwarming tales of love and acceptance, some of them are also tragic examples of the consequences of keeping animals in captivity, such as the case of Pelusa, otherwise known as the purple polar bear, who featured at the center of one of the most insane stories of the past decade. Back in 2003, while being held at the Mendoza Zoo in Argentina, 23-year-old Pelusa was sprayed with an antiseptic spray that turned her normally white fur into a dark shade of violet. Believe it or not, but the unusual color was a temporary side effect for the treatment of dermatitis, a skin condition that caused Pelusa great distress, but was believed to be a result of her being held in captivity. The spray that was applied to Pelusa is thought to be similar to the one used by pediatricians to treat children's scraped knees, or by lab technicians to stain microorganisms for examination under microscopes. Certainly, no one ever thought it would be used to treat a polar bear, although thankfully the side effects of the treatment spray were only temporary. Pelusa sadly passed away back in 2012 after a long string of ill health complications. White giraffe. The death of any rare animal is a tragedy, but this next entry is a particularly cruel case of the malice and brutality that illegal poaching operations often commit in the wild. In the grasslands of Garissa County in Kenya, conservationists were aware of one of the rarest mother and child pairings to have occurred in the wild. only ever captured on film once, the beautiful and incredible rare pair of white giraffes, a mother and her calf, were thought to have suffered from leucism, a disorder which leaves the creatures with a lack of pigment in their skin, similar to that of albinism. Conservationists were aware of this astonishing pairing and had kept a keen eye on the pair for over a year, proud to be the only community in the world who were the custodians of a mother and child pairing of rare white giraffes. However, sadly, in 2017, tragedy struck. After the two giraffes had gone missing for several months, both locals and conservationists at the reserve were worried for their safety, and their worst fears were proven true after the skeletal remains of the animals were discovered. All signs indicated that the animals were killed for their distinctive appearance by an operation of armed poachers, a crime which has plagued conservation sites across Africa for decades. Now, it's believed that only one white giraffe still exists in Kenya, which may very well be the last of its kind in the world. Jersey cow with Jersey map. All right, perhaps we should take this next entry with a little pinch of salt because this sure is a strange one. Without video evidence, it's hard to ultimately tell if this entry isn't somehow photoshopped. But given the fact that two of the leading news agencies in the world reported on it, we'll have to take their word for it. Back in 2015, a calf was born at a farm in Jersey, an island located just off the coast of the United Kingdom, found in the channel crossing between England and France. Jersey is a place known for its unique contributions toward agriculture and its farming, particularly with its breed of Jersey cattle, and it seemed that this calf had something to say about that. You see, the calf was born with a distinct marking on her back that appears to almost perfectly resemble the shape of Jersey. Born on June 29th, the calf was affectionately named Fairy for her almost magical appearance, and she has since been kept by her owners to be pampered and live a life of cattle luxury. Believe it or not, but a farmhand also noted that Fairy appeared to have the map of Poland on her head. Whatever the case, it seems that this calf has gone global. White Doberman Pinschers. All right, it was only a matter of time before we turned our attention back towards canines. And for our next incredible pooch, man's best friend has never been more distinctive. We all love doggos, and Dobermans are no exception, often renowned for their long limbs and goofy behavior. However, one variation of the Doberman Pinscher has since drawn considerable controversy, as many canine advocates believe that breeding this incredibly rare variation is unethical due to the health complications that come with it. Typically speaking, white Dobermans are actually a light cream color with white markings that have distinctive pink noses and lips. Technically, these dogs are not considered to have albinism in the traditional sense, considering the fact that they have distinctive blue eyes, but they have developed an intense reputation for their striking beauty and incredibly unique appearance. Later in life, the health issues that occur in these dogs are numerous, leading many to believe that the white Doberman Pinscher will eventually disappear entirely. They've been the source of great controversy among dog owners and conservationists alike. Piebald deer. Deers are beautiful creatures, without a doubt, and ever since the trauma of Bambi's mother was ingrained into us as youngsters, the vast majority of us can't help but go, "Aw," whenever we see a deer frolicking in the wild. If you're lucky enough to live in an area overrun by growing deer population, you'll know that the standard tawny brown and white-tailed variety are a dime a dozen. However, the elusive and incredible piebald deer is a different kettle of fish, and it has recently been considered to be the unicorn of the deer world, distinguished by its beautiful and astonishing white markings. But what exactly is piebaldism? Well, for those of you that don't know, this coloring is due to a genetic abnormality that leads to a lack of pigmentation and patches around the body. Piebaldism is considered to be a recessive trait, and therefore both parents must carry the recessive gene for there to be a chance that they'll produce a piebald fawn. As you may imagine, that is an incredibly rare event, and when it occurs, the results are this astonishing example of the weird and wonderful complexities of nature. Cupid's penguin. We love penguins, right? Sure, these furry little fellas have captured both our hearts and minds with their slapstick nature and their incredible resilience when facing down a snowstorm. But this awesome emperor penguin takes the title lovebird to the next level. While many of us may figuratively wear our hearts on our sleeve, this little guy shows it off in just the right place. While changing his plumage into adulthood, where penguins usually shed their characteristic fluff for a more streamlined appearance, this white heart-shaped patch appeared on his chest in a natural formation due to the molting of his feathers. While he looks pretty happy with himself, he's also one in a million. Quite literally, his image probably would have never been captured if it wasn't for the award-winning photographer and wildlife filmmaker, Sue Flood, who said that after visiting the Arctic and Antarctic for over 20 years, she'd never before seen a similar penguin phenomenon. Amazing! The spotless cheetahs. They say that a leopard can never change its spots, but how about a cheetah? Back in 2012, for the first time in over a century, the infamous and elusive spotless cheetah was, spotted, for lack of a better term. This incredible and mythical creature was discovered by a British wildlife photographer, Guy Combs, who had heard whisperings of its existence somewhere in a 100,000-acre stretch of the Kenyan wilderness. According to experts, the last recorded sighting of a spotless cheetah was in 1921, although no photograph was captured of the amazing animal. It's believed that its spotless genetic throwback would have actually helped the young adult male thrive in the wild, as it could have possibly been mistaken for a lion by other competing predators. Its spotless appearance is an inherited trait due to a recessive gene, which means it would be something that coincidentally comes from both parents, who wouldn't have outwardly displayed this trait. The King Cheetah. Alright, on the topic of cheetahs, you've seen them without spots, but how about seeing them with these astonishing and accentuated black markings, which amazingly have quite the opposite effect? King cheetahs are exclusively found in Africa and are believed to be an extremely rare occurrence in the wild. Amazingly, the king cheetah has stripes and spots that differ from the common cheetah, which is caused by a similar recessive gene that is found in the spotless cheetah. Tragically, over the past several decades, the cheetah population has declined by nearly 90%, mainly due to poaching and illegal hunting, and the king cheetah population has fallen with it. As of 2016, it was thought that only 30 king cheetahs were left in the wild. Snowflake the gorilla. Meet Snowflake, an incredible animal who was considered to be the world's only known fully albino animal of his kind. As a western lowland gorilla, Snowflake was born in Africa and was captured as a youngster in the jungles of the Equatorial Guinea back in 1966, an event which concluded with the tragic murder of his entire gorilla group. Initially, Snowflake was spared by poachers for his striking white coloring, and he was later sold to a zoo in Barcelona after being rescued, which would become his home until his untimely death from skin cancer in 2003. Upon his arrival to the Barcelona Zoo, Snowflake was given an official red carpet reception by the then mayor of Barcelona, and he was nicknamed Snow White by the Spanish press. It wasn't until 1976, following a mistranslation by the National Geographic magazine, that he was officially dubbed Snowflake, which has since become the hallmark of his distinctive appearance. During his life, Snowflake fathered 22 offspring by 3 different mates. Only 6 of them survived into adulthood. As of May 2014, Snowflake had a total of 21 grandchildren, 11 of which had survived, and 4 great-grandchildren, none of them carrying his distinctive albino appearance. And his great-grandson, Nko, has pink fingers, suggesting a partial display of the gene. Snowflake is considered to be one of the most recognizable Western lowland gorillas in history, and his legacy lives on through his unique appearance and standing out from the crowd. Baby Ben and his 7 head. Alright, for our final entry into the weird and wonderful world of unbelievable animal markings, let's turn our attention towards Baby Ben and his 7 head, perhaps one of the most bizarre and incredible occurrences of its kind in recent times. Born back in 2014 at Valewood Farms in Pennsylvania, Baby Ben was named after the famous Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback Ben Roethlisberger, who famously wore the number 7 on his jersey. Unbelievably, Baby Ben was born with the undeniable appearance of a giant number 7 on his head. And so, Big Ben seemed to be the perfect partner for this weird bovine pairing. it became such a hot topic that many Steelers fans considered Baby Ben to be a good omen for their coming season. And considering the fact that they placed first in their division that year, who knows? Maybe Baby Ben and his seven head was a touch of magic. Well, there we have it, folks. 15 unique animals with unbelievable fur markings. What did you guys think? Make sure to let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. As always, thanks for sticking around all the way until the end. You've been watching Missing Files. See you next time.